Yeah, welcome back. And it was a fiery start to Celebrity MasterChef last night, and Dilruk delivered.
I've never made this before. No, I'm kidding, I'm kidding. I've made it a couple of times, but I've never made it under this kind of pressure.
When I cook, I have to follow a recipe to the T. 1 teaspoon of salt.
Dilruk, did you just measure salt?
Mate, don't be like that.
I'm just asking.
Don't be like that. Yes, I just did.
I have never seen anyone do that. That's amazing.
And also, I've just burnt my coconut because I was too busy measuring salt.
Is Dilruk.
Did anyone see that coming? I won the immunity pit. I feel like I'm Gollum from Lord of the Rings. It's my precious.
Fully deserved. Dilruk joins us now live from Melbourne. Congratulations on winning the only immunity pin. Last night, Melissa shared that her mum makes the recipe that you made last night. The judges are not lenient in this competition. Were you surprised? Do you impress them that much?
Yeah, I think you can see it on my face, right? Like, that's the thing. I pride myself on being a good actor, but I'm not that good. I was genuinely so shell-shocked by the fact that I was even in the top four, let alone to end up winning it. Because for me, like I said on the show, that I've only started cooking about a year ago when the pandemic hit. And so I'm completely out of my comfort zone this entire time. And to know that somehow I managed to pull a rabbit out of my butt, it was pretty good.
Yeah, you did. Considering the way you start off, you were a bit nervous. Jock even laughed at you for measuring salt. He's never seen that before. What changed for you in that cook that made you become Chef Dilruk?
Well, I think it was just, luck. but also, I think, I had to follow everything perfectly because cooking is so much about feeling. Like I'm a stand-up comedian, right? There's no... formula to when you want to do comedy, but after a certain time you start to understand things. It's hard to pinpoint what you're doing. So I understand what Jock says about like measuring salt, but when you're new to it, you got to follow it exactly to the T. And so for me, the fact that I ended up winning after all of that is probably, I think, one of my greatest achievements ever. Especially, I think, getting a Sri Lankan dish like kiribat, which is this milk rice, coconut rice, that is like a very traditional dish, I think is probably an absolute highlight for me.
Well, that's great, because it can go either way, I suppose, when you're new into something. You know, like you said, you only started cooking last year in the lockdown. So at this stage, you probably found your groove. Have you got some favourite things you like to make now?
Oh, now, absolutely, yeah. The beef rendang that I made on the show, I've now, I think, got even better at it. So that is now my, I think if I ever need to impress anyone at a dinner party or something, I'm just bringing beef rendang. But also, you know, I think before the pandemic, like, I lived alone. And, you know, cooking for one person is a nightmare because, you know, you open up a recipe book, it's for a family of four. So immediately I'm crying because I miss mom and dad. Yeah. So then I'm having to divide every ingredient by four and at the shops trying to find like a clove of garlic and one bay leaf. Trying to cook a recipe, and then obviously the ratios are all off, so it tastes like crap. So I put it in the freezer, for whom I don't know, because, you know, like, I'm not going to eat that crap. It tasted bad the first time around, so I never bothered with cooking. It just sits in the freezer, taking up valuable gelato space. Whereas now, thanks to MasterChef, I've actually enjoyed the process of cooking, and, I'm enjoying pushing myself out of my comfort zone.
Awesome. Well, mate, Australia's falling in love with you, mate. You're a famous stand-up comedian. You're a very funny man. You've worked in high-pressure situations. What was it like there in the kitchen, and were the judges quite imposing? We saw them laughing. Which judge sort of gave you the most grief during the challenges?
I would say yesterday's episode, it was all three of them, because you would normally, like, it's hard to put Melissa in that same category, but yesterday when she told me this is her mum makes it and it means a lot to her, the pressure just went through the roof for me. And obviously, Jock's sarcastic roasting sense of humor is very much up my alley. So when he started making fun of me, for me, I guess as a stand-up comedian, we get that, it's a sign of, like, that they respect you if someone makes fun of you. So I enjoyed that aspect of it. And Andy as well. There's a couple of things that maybe didn't make the air that he was there helping me, but at the same time being like, oh, mate, because especially with the pressure cooker has undone a lot of more professional chefs in that kitchen, let alone someone who's having a crack at the first time. But when the judges started eating, especially Jock, I know when he tasted the beef, he was like the cooking monster, just getting right in there, looking his face in there. So I, for me, I think that's when I knew, okay, maybe I've pulled it off here.
Fantastic. It's going to be a great season. Celebrity MasterChef continues tonight at 7:30 on 10 and 10 Play on demand. Dilruk, with your beautiful singing voice, well done on scoring immunity. We can't wait to see what you come up next.
Well done, buddy.